Hey guys, it's Jess and welcome back to my channel. So if you are new here, then you wouldn't know that I have taken quite a leave of absence since talking to you guys. I recently uploaded a video like 2 weeks ago of me singing in one of my shows this summer, but I haven't actually sat down to talk with you guys in probably about 2 months. So I thought I would come back on, explain myself, and share all of the new things that are going to be coming to this channel because I'm just really excited to get back into it. So let's just start with where I was. So this summer I got to do something very, very, very cool, and I was a part of a professional theater company up in Virginia. The theater is called The Prizery and it's in South Boston, Virginia, and I was hired as a performer, as an actress, singer, dancer, performer person to go up and perform for the summer. I was part of their summer stock season. We did Oklahoma, Gypsy, and a cabaret show that was like 4th of July themed. It was just such a really cool experience. So I was up there for 7 weeks, about 2 months. Oklahoma, I played Miss Gertie Cummings, which is the one with the ridiculous laugh if you've not seen that show before. In Gypsy, I played Gypsy Rose Lee, also known as Louise, which was such a just an amazing experience. I want to do another video just like specifically detailing like what I did this summer. So if you guys want to see that, let me know in the comments and by liking this video, and then I will definitely put something up for you guys specifically detailing that. But all in all, the summer was really, really great. However, I was ridiculously busy. We rehearsed 6 days a week, like sometimes 12-hour days, and then I would go home and just want to eat and like fall asleep, or we'd go out with some of the people in the cast and just like have fun. So I really took the summer to kind of work on myself and take time for myself instead of kind of dealing with social media a lot. So YouTube kind of took a back burner thing. I didn't upload on Instagram as much as I usually do. So I was just kind of taking the summer to kind of just really live in the moment, which is not something that I think I do very often. So I was really proud of myself that I did that this summer, which is why basically I was gone. But now we are back. I've been back in Orlando for a little over 2 weeks and it has been just really, really great to get back. I was very sad to leave all of my friends that I made. Also, ignore the thunder. It's currently like pouring outside, which is why I'm making this video now, because I was gonna go out with my friend to Downtown Disney. But as you can hear, it is ridiculously just really, really stormy, so we're here. But anyways, I was really sad to leave all of my friends from the summer because we just made such a tight-knit little family and it was hard to leave my town as small as it was. I really do love South Boston, Virginia, of all places. It was really just such a really special experience. But I've been back in Orlando. I've been working. If you guys didn't know, I work at Universal. I asked them before I left if they could hold my job kind of for me, and if they would let me take 2 months off. And because this job this summer was an internship for me and it counted as part of my grade for school, they were all right by it, and so they let me take 2 months off, which is just really, really amazing. I'm super thankful. And so I've been back working at Universal. I do work in entertainment, and that's about as much as I can say. I can't say much more, but I do work in entertainment at Universal, so that's what I've been doing. I've been working 6 days a week. I've been trying to just kind of get my money back, because I didn't really get paid too much this summer, and all of that money was spent on my rent here, because I had to pay for my apartment here, because I couldn't rent it out, type of deal. Long story, but basically I came back with no money and I really need money. So I've been working a heck of a lot, but I've been loving every single second of it. It's just so good to be back with all of these people that I had to say goodbye to, but now we're back and I'm about to start my last semester of undergrad, which is my last semester of college, because I do not see myself ever doing a master's program or a doctorate, just because that's not really what I want in life. I don't really need that to get to where I want my goals to be, type of deal. So this will likely be my last bit of school. So I have one more semester left. I am currently in the BFA musical theater program at the University of Central Florida, also known as UCF, if you guys didn't know. So I've got one more semester of classes for singing, and we're actually, I don't have any dance classes, but I'll probably take a couple dance classes and acting classes and audition classes. And it's I'm not super excited for it, to be very honest. I'm kind of stressing because I have a lot on my load because it's my last semester, and instead of finishing in the normal like 4 years, I'm finishing in 3.5. So all the classes, like the couple classes I would have taken like in that other year, I'm just kind of smushing them into this last semester so I can just be done, go about my merry way, and try to get jobs, which is now what I want to talk about, is kind of what I'm doing after school. I do post those little Instagram questions quite a lot, those little questionnaire things on my story, and I've answered this one a couple times, but basically I wanted to answer it for all you YouTube people. But if you don't follow me on Instagram, link right here, go check it out. Basically after school, I don't really have a plan, and I do have a plan, so it's a little bit of both. My current plan, if everything stays exactly the same as it is, I will be moving from this apartment because this apartment is near my school. So I'll be moving from this apartment more towards the theme park area and downtown Orlando and moving to an apartment there and just working full-time at Universal while still auditioning for things and trying to get jobs, stuff like that. If something else arises, I have a couple auditions coming up for things that could take me away out of the state, out of the country within the next couple months, and I would be gone kind of that year. I'll be taking that path, but it's really all up in the air right now. I haven't gone to any of these auditions. I'm just kind of hoping that something works out, but if it doesn't, I still have the stuff here, which I'm also very excited about. So either way that this life takes me, I'm going to be fine. We're going to be stable, so it'll be good. And I'm looking forward to all of it. Another thing that a couple of you guys have been asking me recently that I've kind of put off answering until just I felt okay talking about it is about my bunny Lumos. And I would like to start off by saying this, that he's not dead. He is not dead, because every time I tell a story, everyone thinks that he's dead because I start it weird. So he's not dead. But I did make the decision ultimately to bring him back to the rescue that I got him from. It was one of the hardest decisions I've ever had to make, but I realized that I was working so much and I had to be working so much. And so all of the time that I was gone, I couldn't leave him in my room because although it was bunny proofed as much as I could make it, it's also a college apartment dorm. So there's not as much bunny proofing as like I would want him to have his own separate room, which is what I kind of made the bathroom for when I was gone. It was his own little play area. But then I'd come home from 12-hour days and he would have been stuck in the bathroom the entire day, and it killed me. Like it hurt so much to know that he was not as happy as he could be with a person or a family that could take care of him the way that he deserves to. So I felt bad because I felt like I was abandoning him, but I also knew that it was going to be better in the long run for him to go back to the rescue, to be potentially adopted by a much better person or family to watch over him. So I waited until kind of now to announce that. So I haven't had him. I gave him back. I guess surrendered him right before I left for Virginia, because it wasn't a good life for him here, and it killed me to know that I couldn't give him what he deserved. So I brought him back to the rescue in Gainesville, and I think about a month after that, I found out that he had been adopted by a new family that I know is going to love him and take care of him and spend as much time with him as they can. So I'm very, very happy that he's happy now, and now I don't feel bad that I'm essentially just locking him up all hours of the day because I just didn't have time. So on my part, it probably wasn't a wise decision to get him in the first place, and I understand that. But I also know that at that time in my life when I did get him, I was under the impression that I could. So things happen and situations change. And as much as I did want to keep him and, you know, fit my life around him, I also had to worry about myself and worry about his own happiness. So in the long run, long story short, I gave him back to the rescue and they were able to find a new family for him. And now both sides are a lot happier. So Lumos is no longer with me, but I know that he is much happier. So I know I'll probably get a little bit of hate for that whole situation, so come at me, but I know that I did the right thing by giving him back. So yeah, it kind of made me, I didn't want to talk about it because it made me cry for quite a while. So now I'm a lot better knowing that he's happier. So that's that whole situation. But in general, I believe that's all that I have to catch you guys up on. If you guys have any other questions specifically, hit me up on Instagram. Like I said, the link for that will be down below. Ask any questions here on YouTube. I do want to do a Q&A later. I might do a Q&A about my time in Virginia because I think that'll just be easier to kind of answer everything. So if you have any questions for that, leave those below. But thank you guys for sticking around for this long, even though I've been absent, AWOL, whatever. But I am excited to get started back and doing things. I know the semester is going to be really, really busy, but I'm going to try and make the time to upload as much as I can, because I do love documenting things for my own personal purposes as well as to share with you guys things. We recently hit over 15,000 subscribers, which is kind of ridiculous. I am sorry, that's literally crazy. So thank you guys so much. I know some of you guys come up and see me when I'm at the theme parks, so be sure to say hi. If I'm working, respect that, but if I'm not working and I'm just playing, please come up and say hi. I would love to meet you guys. So that's about all for now, but thank you guys so much for watching again. If you have any questions, leave them below, and I'll see you guys in my next video, which should hopefully be up shortly, because we're gonna get back into the game, all right? All right, thanks guys, bye.